Last week, we discussed whether infinity is real and came to the conclusion it is not. This week, I want to talk about a closely related topic, singularities. What are singularities? Where do they appear in physics? And are they real? A singularity is a place beyond which you cannot continue. But singularities in mathematics can be rather dull. In mathematics, a singularity may just be a location where an object, for example a function, is not defined. But it may be not defined just because you didn't define it. If I define, for example, a piecewise function that has the value 1 for x strictly smaller and strictly larger than 0, then that's not defined exactly at 0. You can't go from left to right. So that's a singularity. It is, however, a singularity that is easy to remove just by filling in the missing point. Correspondingly, this is also called a removable singularity. But many functions have singularities that are more interesting than that. The simplest example that's still interesting is the function 1 over x, which has a singularity at 0. This singularity cannot be removed. There is no point you could fit in at 0 that would make this function continuous. You won't get from the left to the right. Or the function 1 over x, that's because the function diverges when x gets close to 0, so the value of the function becomes infinitely large. However, and this is a really important point, a singularity does not necessarily have to come with anything infinite. Take, for example, the function sine of 1 over x, which I have plotted here. This function has a singularity at x equals 0, but that's not because the value of the function becomes infinitely large. It's because there's no such thing as the value of the sine function at 1 over 0. For a mathematician, a function doesn't even have to look odd to have a singularity. The best example is the function e to the minus 1 over x squared. This looks perfectly fine if you plot it. But this function has a really weird property. If you calculate the value of the function and the derivatives of the function at 0, you will find that they are all exactly 0. What this means is that if you reach 0 from one side, you don't know how to continue the function. There are infinitely many ways to continue from there, all of which will perfectly fit to the other side. For example, you could continue with a function that's just constant at 0 and glue this onto the other side. Or you could take the function e to the minus pi over x squared. This type of singularity is called an essential singularity. Okay, so singularities are arguably a thing in mathematics. But do singularities appear in reality? Not for all we currently know. Physicists use mathematics to describe nature, and yes, sometimes this mathematics contains singularities. But these singularities are in all known cases a signal that the theory has been applied in a range where it's no longer valid. Take for example water dripping off a tap. The surface of the droplet has a singularity where the drop pinches off. At this point, the curvature becomes infinitely large. However, this happens only if you describe water as a fluid, which is an approximation in which you ignore that really the water is made of atoms. If you look closely at the pinch-off point of the droplet, then there's no singularity, there are just atoms. There are other examples where singularities appear in physics. For example, in phase transitions, like the transition from a liquid to a solid, some quantities can become infinitely large. But again, this is really a consequence of using certain bulk descriptions in approximation. If you actually look closely, there isn't really anything singular at a phase transition. There's one exception to this, and that's black holes. Black holes are solutions of Einstein's theory of general relativity. They have a singularity in the center. Because it's a common misunderstanding, let me emphasize that there is no singularity at the black hole horizon. There's actually nothing particularly interesting happening at the horizon. It's just the boundary of a region from which you cannot get out. Instead, once you cross the horizon, you will inevitably fall into the singularity. And in a nutshell, this is pretty much what Hawking and Penrose's singularity theorems are about. That in general relativity, you can get situations where singularities are unavoidable because all possible paths lead there. But what happens if you fall into a black hole singularity? Well, you die before you reach the singularity because tidal forces rip you to pieces. But if your remainders reach the singularity, then that's just the end. There's no more space or time beyond this. There's just nothing. At least that's what the mathematics says. So what does the physics say? Is the black hole singularity real? No one knows, because we cannot see what happens inside of a black hole. Whatever happens there is really just pure speculation. Most physicists believe that the singularity in black holes is not real, but that it is instead of the same type as the other singularities in physics. That is, it is just a signal that the theory, in this case general relativity, breaks down, and to make meaningful predictions one needs a better theory. For the black hole singularity, that better theory would be a theory for the quantum behavior of space and time, a theory of quantum gravity, as it's called. Some of you may wonder now what's with the technological singularity. The technological singularity usually refers to a point in time where machines become intelligent enough to improve themselves, creating a runaway effect which is supposedly impossible to predict. It's called a singularity because of this impossibility to make a prediction beyond it, which is indeed very similar to the mathematical definition of a singularity. But of course, the technological singularity is not a real singularity. It may be in practice impossible to predict what happens afterwards, but lots of things are in practice impossible to predict. There is nothing specifically unpredictable about the laws of nature at a technological singularity, if that ever happens in the first place. In summary, singularities exist in mathematics, but we have no evidence that singularities also exist in nature. But given that, as we saw earlier, certain types of singularities do not require any quantity to become infinite, it is not impossible that one day we may discover an actual singularity in nature. In contrast to infinity, singularities are not a priori unscientific. This video was sponsored by Brilliant, which is a website that offers interactive courses on a large variety of topics in science and mathematics. If you want to brush up your knowledge about functions and how to take derivatives and limits, then Brilliant is a great starting point. To get more background on this video's content, I would recommend you look specifically at their courses on calculus and on infinity. To support this channel and learn more about Brilliant, go to brilliant.org/Sabine and sign up for free. The first 200 subscribers using this link will get 20% off their annual premium subscription. Thanks for watching. See you next week.